From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Kirk Smith with what the government believes is enough COVID-19 vaccine secured to inoculate the entire country. The focus now on getting persons to take it and helping persons in hospital already infected with the virus. They're close to capacity levels in hospitals now, but Health Minister Wells says they're working on getting additional beds.
We have in country probably about 100, nearly 140 COVID beds. We have been adjusting our circumstances at PMH. As you know, we have another two wards that's going to come on stream that's going to give us, probably by next week, an opportunity for another 34 beds. We are moving very quickly with the contractors to ensure, because they're like 98-99% completed.
The rollout of the U.S.-donated Pfizer vaccine could begin as early as next week. Prime Minister Minnis urging persons to step up and take the vaccine to protect themselves and others. U.S. Chargé d'Affaires Ursa Pitts is among those urging Bahamians to get vaccinated.
The problem here in the Bahamas is the vaccine hesitancy. So please, please, for the love of God, get vaccinated. Excuses are over. There's plenty of supply. There's plenty of choice. If you won't do it for yourself, do it for your Grammy. And if you won't do it for your Grammy, do it for your country. But get vaccinated so we can get through this and return to normal life.
This is Newsbreak from the Tribune News Network. The Ministry of Health dismissing social media claims that Health Minister Wells was paid an honorarium by the government for his role in the COVID-19 response. Attorney General Carl Bethel says the government is moving to end the continuing controversy over the ownership of companies given COVID-19 contracts by the government. He says they're now trying to get the information released by the relevant officials. Funeral directors have a complaint. They say the existing COVID-19 protocols is leading to long delays at the morgue, which still has more bodies than it was designed to hold. Nothing decided yet. Education officials say they're still in talks on how best to open schools for the fall term, given the increase in the coronavirus numbers. Olympic gold medalist Shaunae Miller-Uwibo says she's shutting down competition for the rest of the year. Another 130 confirmed coronavirus cases for Wednesday. One more death, 311 in total now, more than 130 persons still in hospital. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper on the streets first thing in the morning. Stay up to date online at tribune242.com. Now the Tribune's overnight AccuWeather update, brought to you by Bahamas Power and Light, BPL. Weather associated with that tropical system in the area, mostly cloudy tonight, showers around, overnight lows in the upper 70s and low 80s, 78 at Freeport, 80 in the capital, 79 at Matthewtown. Marine advisories in place, winds up to 20 knots, the seas up to 6 feet, extending into the nighttime hours. Low tide now, the next high around midnight. Saturday's forecast, partly cloudy, some rain could still be in the area, highs in the upper 80s. Your weather update brought to you by Bahamas Power and Light, BPL. Through all severe weather situations, they will be there by your side. This is Newsbreak from the Tribune News Network.
Let the Bahamas and the world know that you're open for business by advertising in the Tribune and on tribune242.com. Reach the market that'll get your cash registers ringing by calling 502-2394 today. Our professional advertising agents are on hand to customize packages just for you, and consultations are free. Give your business the maximum exposure for an affordable investment, and let us help you increase your sales. Call 502-2394 today. We're open for business. Let the world know you are too. The Tribune, the People's Paper. Biggest and best.
World News headlines. Algerian government officials holding a number of persons in connection with the start of wildfires now burning out of control in that country. More than 60 persons have died in those fires. Officials say the initial fires were arson. The U.S. sending 3,000 troops to Kabul, the Afghanistan capital, to help evacuate the embassy there. The Taliban militant group is making rapid progress in their quest to take over the country, and the capital could be next to fall. British officials looking into a rare mass shooting incident in the southwest part of that country. A man shot and killed two men and two women before killing himself. Sports notes now, brought to you by the Tribune Sports section on TV. There's soccer and some golf this weekend. Major League Baseball is on TV tonight. Jazz on the Marlins open a series at home against the Cubs. NFL preseason football is back. The Dolphins play the Bears this weekend. For all of your sports details, you'll want to check the Tribune Sports section. Back on the streets Monday morning. Everything you need from the world of sports you'll find in the Tribune Sports. And that's your news break. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper on the streets first thing in the morning. Stay up to date online over the weekend at Tribune242.com.